You're listening to all-time classic tracks
and forgotten oldies
on Croydon Radio.
Afternoon. How are you? I hope all is well. My name is Evian Cafun and welcome to the latest edition of the Game Video Show live on CroydonRadio.com. Yes, we are back. Thank you very much to Claire for the last hour or so. Thank you very much. Arigato. Merci. Merci. Had a chance to say a quick word. Very pleasant and very nice to meet you. It's very difficult to meet presenters here sometimes. So, you know, the quick word when they go in and out of the studio is always nice and appreciated. We kicked off the show with Toro Minagishi and Shiho Fuji. And that's from Splatoon original soundtrack. And that's entitled Tentacular Circus. Yes, that's from the single player mode of Octo Valley. Have you played Splatoon yet on the Nintendo Wii U? Awesome game. Enough said about that because I've said it probably every week over the last 2 months or so. Crazy. It's been 2 months practically now since the Game Video Show has been broadcasting live here on Croydon Radio. And what a lovely 2 months it has been. We've got so much to go though and so many great guests and goodies and things to come up, including a live event somewhere in this wonderful town of ours called Croydon. Yes, Croydon. Croydon today is currently 18 Celsius. It's 2 minutes past four. We've got plenty of music. Please don't forget, on Facebook, it's Game Video Show, and on Twitter, it's at Game Video Show 1 or Evian Cafun. Don't forget as well at Croydon Radio. Very simple. Follow us online. Anyway, let's kick it off with more music from Splatoon, and this is from the Nintendo Wii U classic. Yes, it's a classic. This is called Maritime Memory. In brackets, Staff Roll. Yeah, baby.
Thank you.
Minagishi, Shiho, Fuji, and that's Maritime Memory, Staff Roll, from the Splatoon original soundtrack. Fantastic, it's great. I love that Staff Roll, the credits on the end of Splatoon there, the single player campaign, when you just basically splat the screen. If you don't splat the screen, you don't actually know who made the game. How cool is that? Yeah, pretty quirky. Hey, you're listening to the Game Video Show with myself, Evian Cafun. If this is your first time tuning in, then thank you very much and welcome to the place where we play video game music, basically. That's what we do. We play music from video games. Let's try not to bite my tongue there. Okay, that would help. Otherwise, I wouldn't be able to speak, but would that be much of a loss? I guess not. Ah, gosh. How naughty of you and depressive, hey? Depressive. Oh, okay. So, this week has been amazing, okay? It's been probably one of the best weeks of 2016. Why, Evian? Tell me why. Okay, so I just logged onto my computer the other day. Yes, my computer, not my smartphone. Went onto YouTube. You know, E3 is going on at the moment, by the way. Or it's just finished, or it's still going on. Yeah, it's just finished, I think. And, okay. And Nintendo, you know, just out of the blue. Well, it wasn't out of the blue, actually. They revealed the trailer for the new Legend of Zelda, Breath of the Wild. Oh, my word. Amazing. Like, seriously. Oh, my God. There's nothing else I can say. The game is just looks brilliant. I just really want to play it. And, you know, they've made it open, this open world sort of thing. And it's just brilliant, you know. You know, Link before, you couldn't make Link jump by himself before, you know, the main character of Legend of Zelda. But now he can jump and he can climb and he can do all these cool things and he can glide off cliff faces and, you know, change his clothes. I mean, this is all just great for people that have played the Legend of Zelda since, you know, A Link from the Past or, you know, etc. So this is amazing. And I just can't wait to play it. It comes out next year, 2017, approximately July, I believe. And yeah, it's going to be out on the Nintendo Wii U and the Nintendo NX, which is their new console. Ha 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 ha! A new Nintendo console, which I cannot wait to play. Yes, take my money, Nintendo. Take my rupees. Can't wait to play it. It's going to be good. It's going to be great. It's going to be gorgeous. Because it does look gorgeous. It really does. Anyway, on that Nintendo Legend of Zelda theme right now, we're going to play this one from, you know, the ultimate classic from the Legend of Zelda series. But this looks like it may top it. I actually say now that this looks like it's going to top, you know, one of my favorite Zelda games, Ocarina of Time. Yes. We're going to play something from this wonderful soundtrack composed by Kenji Kodo. Oh, sorry. It's not Kenji Kodo. It's Koji Kondo. I'm thinking of another composer from Nintendo. I've just, like, you know, mixed their names together. It's like their love child, and I've just, you know, given them a child, basically, and called it Kenji Kodo. It's a Koji Kondo, and this one is the title theme from The Legend of Zelda, Ocarina of Time.
Thank you.
Koji Kondo, the title theme from The Legend of Zelda, Ocarina of Time. That was out on the Nintendo 64 way back when, the time of cartridges. Wow, what a great game that was. Fantastic. That was probably the benchmark of all Legend of Zelda games, unless you're, you know, proper nostalgia freaks would say that's the best ever, never can be topped. But I disagree. There are so much great games within the Legend of Zelda series, including Wind Waker, Skyward Sword, Twilight Princess, etc., etc., etc. We can go on all day. But yes, the new Legend of Zelda game looks tremendous. Breath of the Wild. Please check out the trailer if you get a chance on YouTube. Just type in new Zelda game or something like that and you'll see the trailer. It looks fantastic. You can chop trees, man. You can cook. You can shoot a flaming bow and arrow at, you know, goblins and, boko goblins as they're called, and raid their camps and stuff like that. Or you can just be a nice guy and ride around with your horse or, you know, run around with a wolf. It's very cool. Yeah, very good. Can't wait to play that. Oh, man, so good, so good. You know what? I'm going to play something else from another Legend of Zelda game here. This one's from The Wind Waker. It's called File Select. Yeah, that's actually what it's called, because it's the part when you select your file to play the game again. And this one's composed by Atsuko Asahi, Atsuka Hayazaki, Hajime Wakai, and Kenta Nagata. Yeah, it's quite a big team there, four people. Almost like this is like the Beatles of Nintendo, almost, apart from Koji Kondo, who's not here at the moment. But yeah, it's pretty much a dream team with this one here. And it does show. It does show with this one. I love it. I love it. Have a listen. So great, isn't it? Just like a nice piece of cake, isn't it? Just like a little chunk. Really cool, really cool. That was File Select, and that's from The Wind Waker original soundtrack, The Legend of Zelda, obviously, by Kenta Nagata, Hajime Wakai, Atsuka Hayazaki, and Atsuko Asahi, Nintendo Dream Team there. Yes, absolutely amazing. Wind Waker is a brilliant game. It originally came out on the Nintendo GameCube a long time ago, which was shaped like a cube, and it was blue, and it had these tiny little discs that no one could, really find anywhere else. They were really small. GameCube, it was one of those underrated consoles, but it had a lot of good games on it, obviously. Oh, man. I mean, the Mario Kart on that in a console itself was really good. I loved it. I loved it. I actually liked that console a lot, and I liked the controller as well. It was a console that, you know, I mean, every Nintendo console gets slack every generation all the time, you know, because they hold such a place in people's hearts and people want them to make another N64 or something like that. But, you know, Nintendo always innovate. They also elevate as well. But they're great. They seriously are. Look at all that rhyming. Innovate, great, elevate. Gosh, might have to start rapping or something here. Really, really good, though. But I love the Wind Waker. It's a great game. I love the art style. And I noticed as well, the latest art style on Breath of the Wild, The Legend of Zelda, is very reminiscent of the Wind Waker as well. It seems to be that cel-shaded look. And I've also noticed as well that they're paying particular attention to the environment in the Breath of the Wild. It seems to be very Celtic inspired as well. It looks a lot like you're running through somewhere in Ireland or Wales or parts of Scotland. It really comes across like that. There is another desert sort of place that I saw in there, and I wonder what that's like. But it does remind me of somewhere in like Snowdonia or something like that, which is really cool. There's a voice that Link hears at the start of the trailer as well, and that, you know, everyone's speculating that could be Zelda herself. But she has an English accent, which is a first in the Zelda franchise as well, which is really good to hear that as well, because I think that the developers themselves are really trying to, you know, be a bit more accurate with you know, where The Legend of Zelda is inspired, you know, from, which is that whole Celtic background full of magic, etc. And it's amazing. Seriously, is. Yeah, I think you really need to have a look at that trailer when you get a chance. It's really cool as well because Link himself, he has a stamina gauge as well. So he climbs up these cliff faces and monuments and, you know, climbs down, you know, little waterfalls and goes into shrines. And, you know, you can't just keep running. You can't just keep climbing. You've got to watch your stamina gauge. And that's another really good thing because if you're going to climb a big cliff face, you know, you have to really think about if you're going to climb that and not fall on your backside. So, yeah, I can't wait to play it. It looks great. I've noticed as well that the sort of dungeons have been replaced by these sort of things called shrines, which is sort of a nod to the Japanese heritage of The Legend of Zelda as well, which is really cool. Each shrine has a guardian as well, which you have to, you know, get past the guardian and, you know, get into the shrine itself and find out, you know, basically pass the task. So each shrine has, you know, different things that you can gain from it, different, you know, powers or weapons, etc. So you're going to be kept busy for a long time playing this game. I mean, they probably won't have to make another Zelda game for at least 6 or 7 years after it, which is really good. They're really trying to make the game big and vast and amazing. And I cannot wait to play it. It's probably my second most anticipated game after Shenmue next year in December, which is going to be coming out on the PS4. I also want to play The Last Guardian as well on the PS4 as well, which is going to be absolutely amazing. Have you seen that trailer? Please check the trailer out. You can check it out on my actual Facebook feed as well, which is Evian Cafun or Game Video Show. Have a look at The Last Guardian trailer. It's amazing. Seriously, it looks amazing. Made by the same team that made Ico or Shadow of the Colossus as well. Absolutely amazing. Seriously, gorgeous, awesome. Yeah. It looks great. Can't wait to play that. Anyway, enough Nintendo butt-kissing here. We're going to move on to some more music now. This music itself was on a trailer that I absolutely loved. It was by Capcom, the makers of Street Fighter V. And, oh, man, when I saw this trailer and it revealed a character that I really love, Charlie Nash, man, the music just blew me away. It just really fit. You know, the way that Nash came into the trailer, a real, you know, bad guy, and just, you know, you're just like, yeah, fist pump, hit your desktop computer screen. But, you know, it was cool. But yeah, no, I was really happy when I heard this song. And yeah, they're quite an elusive group. They seem to do a lot of soundtracks and that sort of thing. They're called Epic Score. It's quite a lot of composers here, but they call themselves Epic Score. And this one is called Nothing Can Keep Me Away. It's from the Street Fighter V Charlie Nash trailer. It's awesome. Seriously, it is very, 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 very epic. Wow. Isn't that great? That is great. Seriously. What I suggest you do is you watch that with the actual trailer itself. It just, the sound effects and the moves and everything that's happening in the trailer is so intense. You know, you just watch Charlie Nash beating up Chun-Li and Ryu and or Ryu, you know, and kicks Ryu onto this like train that he just teleports out of nowhere. It's just epic, literally. The song's epic. The trailer's epic. Charlie Nash is epic. Yeah, seriously. I'm not very good with Charlie Nash at all. I'm not very good with the sort of charger type players. You know, I prefer just to button bash my way to glory. But Charlie Nash is a joy to watch with someone that can actually play with him. Charlie Nash and Guile as well in Street Fighter V. But, oh gosh, fantastic. Seriously, that is just a brilliant soundtrack as well. I noticed that they've ripped apart Charlie Nash, literally, in the game. He looks like some sort of a puppet. He's got that that little gem on his forehead, which is reminiscent of, is it Gil or somebody else that put it on his forehead? I'm not sure. Is it Nakali from Street Fighter V? Or is it Bison? We don't know. We see Bison wake him up at that trailer, that brilliant trailer that they made for Street Fighter V. So, yeah, I haven't actually played the Player One campaign yet. So I heard it's a bit, you know, unfinished, et cetera, but, hey, you know, you get what you're given. And, you know, Street Fighter V is a great game. Hey, it's very good. Very good, obviously. Obviously, it's the benchmark, isn't it, for all fighting games out there. You know, the benchmark and others follow. Talking of Street Fighter V, we're going to go into this one here. It's a fantastic theme tune for the character called Nakali. Yeah, he looks very dangerous. He's got those big sort of dreadlocks all over his head that just go down to the floor. Amazing character. Yeah, he just looks crazy. And then when he charges up, his hair turns into sort of like fire. It looks amazing. I need to play the game. I'll probably be totally useless with him, but anyway. Oh man, seriously, Street Fighter V looks great. Looks great. Anyway, this one is composed by Hiroyuki Fukusawa and Masahiro Aoki. This is from Street Fighter V and it's the Nakali theme. Awesome. Seriously. Street Fighter V really went out of their way on this soundtrack here. I'm very impressed with some of the compositions that I've heard on it. They are all blinding, literally. They just blow your socks off. I recommend playing this game with a good stereo system hooked up to your TV and not one of those little sound bars that people have now with that sort of tinny sound. You want something that really has some bass. Get a bass box. You can get them for really cheap. Get some speakers, you know, on the side for your treble. Put four speakers around your room, put it on a nice big screen and just play, and then you'll get the full effect. Yeah, seriously, yeah. Insane geek moment there. Hashtag geek moment. You're listening to the Game Video Show with myself, Evian Cafun. If this is your first time listening, then welcome, welcome. We play video game music from 4 p.m. to 6 p.m. every Thursday here on CroydonRadio.com. Don't forget to share the word. We're also social as well. You can check us out on Twitter. It's at EVIANCAFUN and also on Facebook, Game Video Show. Keep it locked. We've got so much good music here, but we'll kick it off or keep it rolling with this one, Nakali theme. Yeah, baby. We'll be right back. absolutely awesome. I love that. It's fantastic, isn't it? It's so great. So great. Masahiro Aoki, Hiroyuki Fukusawa, and that one is Nekali theme from Street Fighter V, currently out now on the PlayStation 4 and the PC. Great, I think that's really cool that they at least extended it to the PC there, Sony. That is a really, really nice move. Or was it Sony or was it Capcom? It's probably Capcom themselves, but hey, I think Sony funded the whole thing. So you have basically a cross-platform play, which is really good. So anyone playing on the Sony PS4 can play against someone playing on the PC, which is really good. I don't know how it works technically, but it sounds like a good plan. Does anyone have any experience playing online Street Fighter 5? Let me know. Tweet me at Evian Cafun, and let me know how it's going for you. Are you getting beaten every day on Street Fighter 5? Have you won a game on Street Fighter 5? Let me know. Do you beat everyone every day? I'd be interested to hear from someone who is just like a king at, or a queen at Street Fighter 5, because I can't win. I cannot win. I try to pull off one Hadouken and that's about it. And they just knock me off the stage with whoever they're playing with. Yeah, so it's not very good. You know, I like to watch the trailer and retweet it. That's me. I've done my bit for Capcom. You know, they got enough money. You're listening to the Game Video Show with myself, Evian Cafun here. We play video game music until 6 p.m. each and every Thursday. Yes, plenty of video game music. E3 was this week. If you didn't hear me talking about it earlier, raving about the latest Legend of Zelda, there was plenty of other great games and great announcements from the other companies like Sony PlayStation as well. They spoke about a Crash Bandicoot remaster. Oh my God, do you remember Crash Bandicoot? Remaster as well. Can you imagine how glorious that's going to look on a PS4? It's just going to look amazing, isn't it? And I'm really happy that they're remastering this game because it's such a good platformer as well. It's so reminiscent of, you know, Rayman and, you know, things like that. And what's the other one as well? Oh, I can't remember the name of it now. Ratchet and Clank. Is it Ratchet and Clank? Yeah, as well. You know, I love Crash Bandicoot, though. It's such a good game. And, you know, Sony as well, they made a lot of original platformers that, you know, were very, very good. Very, very good games. And I really can't wait to play the latest Crash Bandicoot. I love the soundtrack as well. And I'm going to play you something from it now because I'm talking about it. From the first Crash Bandicoot here. It's by Josh Mansell. And it's the main theme from Crash Bandicoot on the Sony PlayStation 1. Yes, that grey console, which had probably the best startup noise in history, didn't it? I think the only thing that comes top is Sega. That was number one, obviously. But Sony PlayStation's noise, that that's how it went. Did it go something like that? It probably sounded nothing like that. But yeah, that was just the best like startup ever. I loved it. And with the way that the little diamond shape changed into the... Oh, man, I want to get a Sony PlayStation 1. That's just so much memories, you know. I bet everything just looks terrible on it now, but, you know, so clunky. I remember playing Destruction Derby on it, and I watched it the other day. I was like, yeah, I love Destruction Derby. And I was like, whoa, it looks so hard to play. That hurts my eyes. Yeah, but, oh, man. Oh, it's such a good console, though, wasn't it? You know, Sony PS1 was great. PS2, amazing. I never owned a PS3. I just fell out of it then. I just started to go back to Nintendo. But yeah, I love the PS2 and the PS1. They're so good. One of my favorite games on the Sony PlayStation 1, Sony PlayStation 2 actually, was Bushido Blade. Do you remember that game? Oh my God, what a classic. Seriously. Well, you could take someone out with one slice with your katana or whatever character you were playing with. It was just great though. Such an epic game. I'm going to get some music from that over the next couple of weeks to play you. Need to get my nostalgia headphones on again and listen to some Bushido Blade music. But anyway, let's get back to what we were talking about now. Crash Bandicoot remaster coming out next year sometime for the Sony PS4, which is going to be epic. I know they will do a good job with that. They're going to take their time, you know, hence the reason they announced it. So they're going to make it good. But this is the main theme. This will bring back some memories if you used to play this game because it's classic. It's a classic. And the music is so good as well. Have a listen. We'll be right back. Josh Mansell, the main theme from Crash Bandicoot on the Sony PlayStation 1. Oh, yes. Classic, classic, classic. What a console. It was an ugly-looking console, though, wasn't it? It was that really, like, you know, plasticky. Well, all consoles were plasticky, but it wasn't like, didn't look like the N64 or anything like that. It looked like a CD player, and that's kind of what it was. But, boy, wasn't people wrong when they played that console. It had such good games on it, seriously. As much as I love the Sega Dreamcast, Sony PlayStation 1 had so many good titles on it. There was so many good games. They acquired everybody to make games for their console, and they done a good job. Great console, seriously, really good. I mean, the Sega Dreamcast was actually more powerful than the Sony PlayStation 1. It looked better, and a lot of the games that were on there looked nicer. And so even on the PS2 as well, it could definitely easily match the PS2 or some games better it. But hey, it's about the titles, and if there's not, you know, not many games that people like, etc., it's not going to do so well. But I love the Sega Dreamcast. It was great. So many great games on it as well. So many amazing games, and I still play them to this day. It's amazing. Yes, very much so. Very much so. Oh, yes. Game nostalgia day today. Anyway, let's get back into the present day today. That would help. We're going to play two now from the awesome Namco, Bandai Namco game, the makers of Tekken, but this one is Pokken Tournament. You see what they did there with that? Pokemon and Tekken, Pokken. There you go. Pokken Tournament. We've made a new franchise. We'll be right back. That's nice, isn't it? What a journey that was. Brilliant. Love that. Hashimoto Hiroki, and that's Mystery Carnival from Pokken Tournament. Yeah, that's a great game. Oh, good game there on Nintendo Wii U. I'm not good at it at all. I still can't get used to it. I'm still getting beaten. It's still not happening for me. But hey, it happens. You can't be good at everything unless you're, you know, just some crazy genius who doesn't see daylight all day. But there are some people like that. And yeah, anyway. Really good game, though. I love it. And some of the music is really cool and upbeat. And it does fit the game very well. That one's a bit insane. That's called Mystery Carnival. Yeah, the Mystery Carnival. Yeah, love it, love it, love it. Game video show here live on CroydonRadio.com. We are live from Croydon as well. We're not in Wimbledon or anywhere else. We're in Croydon. We're authentic. Yes, we are. Indeed, indeed. It's currently 18 Celsius today. It's nice. It was quite chilly yesterday in Croydon, but it's picking up. It's looking good. And summer, you know, should be officially here right now, but we never know. This is why we play games a lot in London and the UK in general, because the weather is not great most of the time. But hey, we play a lot of games. We do. A lot of crazy gamers here. Going to get into another one now from Pokken Tournament. It's another good one. Me like it very much, and I'm sure you'll like it as well. This one is one of my favorites from the actual soundtrack itself. Another one from Hashimoto Hiroki. It's good. I love it. I love it. I really do. I usually hear this a lot with my own character that I use on a Pokken Tournament. Chandelure, really cool character. Got such great moves, I just can't win. I don't know what's going on. I need some tutorial tips. I need to go on YouTube and watch some tutorial on using Chandelure effectively to beat everyone. Yeah, yeah, hopefully there'll be some video out there because such a good character. Chandelure is like basically a character, a Pokemon that looks like a chandelier. If you ever watched Pokemon before, you'll know, but such a good character. Isn't that cool, though? A chandelier character just spins around and whacks you in the face with the big, you know, the light bulbs in the mouth and stuff like that. Yeah. Bit crazy and violent. But hey, we love Pokken Tournament here on Game Video Show. And the soundtrack is lovely. This is great. This is called Haunted House by Hashimoto Hiroki from the Pokken Tournament soundtrack. Currently out now on Nintendo Wii U. That's nice. Hashimoto Hiroki, Haunted House and Pocken Tournament there, live here on the Game Video Show with myself, Evian Cafun. I like that very much. Good game, great music as well. Ah, yes. Good game. Need to get better at it. That's the aim for this week. Get better at Pocken Tournament. Note. Oh, man. Yeah, seriously, I'm not good at that game at all. Oh, man. I've had, like, it's really embarrassing as well when you play Pocken Tournament online because it puts up your, you know, how many games you've won or fights or whatever. There's zero wins on my one, about 25 losses. It just doesn't look good. It looks like one of those terrible boxers. It just doesn't, you know they're just coming for a payday to get beat up. And this is what it looks like with me as well. I'm just coming for no payday just to get beat. It's not great. But anyway, I need to practice more on Pocken Tournament and actually win a game. Yeah, that would count. I have had, you know, some good, you know, almost as well with some people that had like 1,000 wins or something like that. How do you even get 1,000 wins for a game that's been out for a few months? Maybe someone Japanese or something. But yeah, I nearly beat them anyway. Almost, you know, it was so close. So close. But anyway, it doesn't really count, does it? So close. They should have that as some sort of statistic in the middle. Wins, zero. So close, 25. Losses, 24. That would make it better, you know, like a so close one. I think that's something that they need to incorporate on every single fighting game. That will help people like me who can't win. Oh, man. Anyway, let's get into something else now. Everyone was hoping for a big announcement from Nintendo regarding this game here. And there was a lot of people online hashtagging and saying, come on, Nintendo, we've got Legend of Zelda. Let's do this game as well. You know, but you can't be greedy and it's not always going to go the way that you plan. But anyway, it doesn't really matter because, you know, we've got the music here. We've got the music. It goes by the name of Mother 3. It came out originally on the Game Boy Advance way back when. Do you remember that game? Oh, man. Such a good game as well. And I love the music as well from Sakai Shogo, which was just blinding. Lovely. The whole soundtrack is just great. I think it's like 77 tracks on it as well. You know, some of them are not full songs, etc. Some just sound effects. But, man, great. Really cool. And I actually tweeted Sakai Shogo over the week as well and just said, oh my god, is it really you? And he just, you know, replied back all coolly, yes, it's me, or yes, I am. That was it. And I was like, ah, cool. So I'm now following Sakai Shogo on Twitter, so let's tweet this over to him now that we're playing his great music, because it's really great. This is two from Mother 3 from the Game Boy Advance, Nintendo Game Boy Advance, and this one is called 16 Melodies. Not Melodies. Did I say Melodies? 16 Melodies. And in brackets, it says beginning. Okay? Yeah. If you play the game, then you kind of have an idea of where this plays. But, you know, if you haven't, don't worry. Because just listen to the music because it's cool. It's really cool. Game Video Show live here on Croydon Radio. Have a listen to this one. Yeah, baby.
Thank you.
awesome. Oh my gosh, that's amazing. Shogo Sakai, 16 Melodies, Beginning. That is brilliant from the Mother 3 game. Original soundtrack as well, composed fully by Shogo Sakai. Great. Seriously, this whole soundtrack is brilliant. It's really good. Considering it came out on the Game Boy Advance, it's still so great to listen to as well. I just actually listen to this. Yes, I do. All 77 tracks, and they're just amazing, every single one. And they all just, you know, portray the feeling of such a brilliant game as well. And Mother 3 has never had an official release here in the UK as well, and I'm pretty sure the USA as well. The UK. It's known as Earthbound out here as well. And, you know, they haven't had official releases, which is, you know, beyond me. There's no official English translation for this game. And, you know, people are wondering, is it going to be put out? Is it going to be released? Please release it. We want to play it. So we're still waiting patiently for this one to come out, Nintendo. So please do release it, because it's such a good game. So much fun to play. It would be really good if they could put it out on the virtual console on the Nintendo Wii U for us to play. Let's get that going. There is an unofficial translation as well that somebody has done for Mother 3 as well. So you can actually play it if you can find it. But I'm not going to tell you where you can find it, obviously, just in case. It's out there. It's out there. There are some fans that just can't wait. And, you know, good on them. Anyway, good on them. Anyway, we're going to play another one from Shogo Sakai, and this one's called Memory of Life, from the Mother 3 soundtrack, original soundtrack as well, on the Game Boy Advance, and it's good, so good. I love the music from here, and considering the time as well that this came out all those years ago, Game Boy Advance, you know, this is, you're talking over 15, 16, 18 years ago now, wowzers, and the music really stands up there, especially on the system that it was on as well. If you're thinking, remember, now, this is before, you know, they had, like, real sort of music, what you know as now in these video games, with these huge orchestras, etc., and the music is so, so moving and powerful sometimes as well. It's very good, very good music as well. So I'm going to play another one here from Mother 3, Memory of Life. Yeah, sounds like one of those, you know, this is your life, Memory of Life. Yeah, it's great. You're listening to the Game Video Show. It's now 5 p.m. on the dot. We are here for one more hour of great music. So stay locked and listen to video game music for one more hour. Here is Shogo Sakai, Memory of Life, from Mother 3 on the Game Boy Advance. Thank you. Memory of Life, and that's Shogo Sakai. Nice, very cool. I love that. And that's from Mother 3 on the Game Boy Advance. Absolutely awesome. The whole soundtrack is brilliant. Love it to pieces. Really, really cool. Yes, we need an updated edition of that. Please, please, come on. We need the English translation official by Nintendo Virtual Console. Let's do it. Let's do it, Nintendo. Come on, make it happen. You've already fulfilled dreams with Legend of Zelda, Breath of the Wild. Now, come on, just do a small announcement. It doesn't have to be a massive announcement. Just sneak it onto the Virtual Console for us in nice English translation. That'd be great, because I cannot read hiragana, katakana yet. Anyway, no problem. Anyway, we're going to get into something now which was highly inspired by Mother 3. It's a very highly acclaimed game as well, by someone who made the whole game by himself, the whole soundtrack by himself. He goes by the name of Toby Fox, and this is music from Undertale. Yes, awesome. Actually had a chance to speak to Toby briefly on email, and he was happy that his music was being played. He's happy for it to be played, which is great. That's always good to hear as well, that creators love their music to be heard. Really talented composer as well, and his music, you know, speaks for itself when you have a listen to it here. It mixes, you know, 8-bit, 16-bit sounds with up-to-date modern processors as well. He actually uses FL Studio, or Fruity Loops, as we all remember it from back in the days, which is even more impressive as well. You know, considering Fruity Loops is not, you know, it's not Adobe this or blah, blah, that, or Pro Tools this. You know, he does a great job, but it's, you know, it's not, you know, how much you have, it's how you use it. And the quality comes out very clear in this one here. It's amazing. And this one is called Megalovania, and it's by Toby Fox from Undertale. And it's very, very good. Have a listen to this one. You may like it. Here on the Game Video Show. We'll be right back. Brilliant, isn't it? Toby Fox, Megalovania. And that's from the Undertale original soundtrack there. Also packaged in with the game itself, Undertale. You can buy that now on Steam. Steam Online, amazing. So good. Great game as well. Well done to Toby Fox for making such an amazing piece of work there. I'm hoping he's working on something new. He's very secretive and guarded about what he's doing next, which is good. He's not even taking interviews at the moment as well, which is a shame because we were trying to get him on the show. But no problem. He's so courteous and nice, and he's really happy that the music is being played, which is very cool as well. So great. Amazing, amazing, amazing. We're going to play another one from Toby Fox in just a moment as well. But don't forget, online, it's Game Video Show on Facebook and also at EVIANCAFUN on Twitter. Follow us. And don't forget to follow at Croydon Radio as well to get all of your updates and the latest tracks that we are playing at the moment. You can get them tweeted and you can retweet them to yourself. And to your friends. You don't want to retweet to yourself because no one's going to really see it. But yeah, if you retweet it to your friends, they'll be, you know, they could see what you're listening to right now with the hashtag now playing. We do it for every single track that is played on this show and others as well. So yeah, it's pretty good. Definitely. We like it. Okay, so let's get into another one here from Undertale. This one's called Battle Against a True Hero. Yes. A battle against a true hero. Yeah, so this person is a true hero. It's another one from Toby Fox as well, from the Undertale original soundtrack as well, which is blinding, as you just heard. And if you just missed it, you could listen to the podcast. The podcast will be up tomorrow from 9 a.m. GMT, obviously. And you can listen to it then and check out, you know, what happened on this show in the past. And also, you know, other podcast editions of the Game Video Show and other shows here on Croydon Radio as well. So it's pretty good. Listen to our podcasts and share them with your friends. Anyway, let's get into this one here from Toby Fox. It's amazing. It's great. It's a battle against a true hero, Undertale. brilliant. Toby Fox, Battle Against a True Hero, from the Undertale original soundtrack. Live here on the Game Video Show. I love that. I love the whole soundtrack. It's so good. The game's good. The soundtrack's amazing. It's just brilliant. Really good. Really, really, really great piece of work, and shows what you can do when you put your mind to something. Hey, that is one person that made that whole soundtrack and game. Wow. Wow. Mindblown.com. Literally. Oh my gosh. Anyway, we're here till 6 p.m. It's the Game Video Show with myself, Evian Cafun. We play video game music each and every week, each and every Thursday. Lots of video game music from all platforms, all consoles. We do not discriminate. We play video game music. We've got some great guests coming up over the next couple of weeks as well. One of them is Adam Pearson. Can't wait to get him on. It's going to be fantastic. Going to get that all sorted out and in just a moment over the next coming days. That's going to be very fun, and other people to be named as well. It's going to be great. Game Video Show will also be having a live event in conjunction with Playnation Games here in Croydon as well. Daniel and the team, it's going to be amazing. We're going to get something sorted out for you soon. Details will be coming up very soon, which will be enable you to play games and listen to video game music courtesy of myself live. That'd be great, won't it? You can do cosplay if you like, but you don't have to. You don't have to. A Mario hat will do, or nothing. Just come as you are. It doesn't matter, seriously. Anyway, let's get into another one here. We're going to go We're going to do some Nintendo 3DS now. We're going to do... This has got to be one of the craziest anime I've ever seen. It's so fun. It was originally a video game, though. It's developed in Fukuoka, my current favorite city in Japan. It's the only one I've been to. But it's still an amazing city. It's great there. And this is just it's like the soundtrack of my house. My daughters love it. They love the anime. And we're going to play something from the game itself as well. But yeah, the anime and the game itself has probably some of the most infectious music you'll ever hear in your life. It just gets into your brain and stays there. It goes by the name of Yokai Watch. Yeah, Yokai Watchi. And this one is by King Cream Soda. It's the title theme from Yokai Watch on a Nintendo 3DS. And it's just brilliant. It's awesome. It's great. It's fantastic. Have a listen. You'll love it. Get up and dance, or do what you have to do, you know. And as they say in the song, get up, get up, oh, get up, get up, oh, get up, get up, oh, get up, get up. That's what they say in the song. Anyway, yeah, let's go. Ha ha ha. That's great. That's the title theme from your guy watch, King Cream Soda. I think there's another composer on this as well. I need to check that out and find out for sure. But that's great. That's from the Nintendo 3DS. The actual theme tune of the anime as well is the get up. I'm going to play that next week as well. It's so good. But the whole all the soundtracks and the music from it is so good. My daughters know all the dances to it as well. They know everything. Actually, when I went to Fukuoka in Japan, there was some yokai watch display there because it's made in Fukuoka by level five. And the whole town is just covered with the characters from the show, like Jibanyan and Koma-san and, you know, Jinmenken and all of these crazy anime characters from the series as well. Yokai Watch is basically there's this young boy who ends up in a forest and finds this little machine, and there's a ghost speaking to him. Yokai is basically a spirit or a ghost, so it's basically Ghost Watch or Ghost. Seems like a bit like Ghostbusters actually, but you're not busting any ghosts. You beat the ghosts in a one-to-one battle, and then they become your friend. You get them as a little coin, and you put anytime he needs help to beat another yokai, he puts the coin in his watch and out pops this yokai, and usually nothing happens, or not, you know, it's just usually a big joke because no one actually fights anyone in Yokai Watch. It's just craziness, absolute nutty craziness. Please watch it, and if you do get a chance, there is a US dub for it, an American dub, but the actual Japanese subtitles are just absolutely insane. I think my favorite episode of the Yokai Watch anime is the one where Koma-san goes to a ramen restaurant in and basically the ramen chef basically has rules on the wall. And it, you know, it's different things, saying like no taking photos, no selfies, no talking when you're eating ramen, no nothing, basically. And Koma-san, this little dog character, spirit dog, you know, breaks all the rules. He takes pictures of the ramen and, you know, it's just mad. And the ramen chef, you know, allows him to do all of this. And the person that Koma-san comes with, this guy, this crazy sort of journalist type guy, is like, how is he getting away with all of this stuff? You know, and he doesn't understand. And that journalist eventually gets kicked out, and Koma-san, you know, gets the respect to the ramen chef, but it's just absolutely madcap stuff. Seriously, you have to play the game Nintendo on the Nintendo 3DS Yokai Watch or watch the anime, which is what I would suggest that you do. It's madness. Seriously, crazy, crazy. Anyway, let's get into something else from the crew down in Fukuoka here. This one is from a composer that I've been playing over the last couple of weeks. He goes by the name of Nishiura Tomohito, and this one is Espella's theme number one from Professor Layton versus Phoenix Wright Ace Attorney. Yeah, I always do that every week, but it's fantastic. The soundtrack is really good, and he does such a great job with Professor Layton's side. I'm pretty sure he handles most of the other themes for Professor Layton and the other games that he has as well, but this is great. Have a listen to it. You're live listening to The Game Video Show here until 6 p.m. Yeah. Thank you. Ah, oh, that's lovely, isn't it? That's Tomohito Nishiura, and that's Espella's theme from Professor Layton versus Phoenix Wright Ace Attorney. Yeah, I love that game. So good. So good. Out now on the Nintendo 3DS. Yes. What a great game that is. But hey, the music is also equally awesome as well. We're going to play another one from it as well because I love it so much. It's so good. Seriously. So good. So good. Oh, gosh. Don't forget as well, you can follow us easily online. It's the Game Video Show on Facebook and also at EVIANCAFUN on Twitter as well. You can check us out there. Very simple, very straightforward. So, yes. Oh, man. So good. Let's play another one now. This is from Tomohito Nishiura as well. This is called Quiet Moments. This one, I really like it. Really just sits there on you. All the Professor Layton music is just, you know, up my street, you know. It's that sort of mysterious and, you know, looking around and searching for the right, you know, thing to click, etc. Professor Layton, such a good game. The anime is really good as well. I watched the anime. Such a good anime. Very well done. And, you know, congrats to Level 5 for finding the people to get it right. Oh, excuse me. But it's really, really cool. Really good. This one's called Quiet Moments here from Nishiura Tomohito from Professor Layton versus Phoenix Wright, Ace Attorney. Yeah. Tomohito Nishiura, Quiet Moments, Professor Layton versus Phoenix Wright, Ace Attorney. Oh man, love it. I love that. That's a really good soundtrack as well. That and Mother 3 have been on rotation on the headphones, you know, listening and doing other things. It's good to listen to and gets you in the zone for whatever you need to do. Fantastic. Really good, really good. I love that. Hopefully one day we can probably get Tomohito Nishiura on the show as well. That would be really cool, really cool. Anyway, let's get into another one now. We don't have long to go, actually. It's just under half an hour now here on the Game Video Show. Don't forget we're here every week on the Game Video Show from 4 p.m. to 6 p.m. here on CroydonRadio.com. Oh, yes. But let's get into this one. Now, I like this. I haven't actually played the game properly as well, but I love the music. The music is very good. It's from a very good-looking game as well called Kid Icarus Uprising. It's another Nintendo one, yep. I know Dark Pit himself and Icarus, etc., from the Super Smash Bros. On the Nintendo Wii U that we play. You know, you used to play quite a lot with my daughters, but we stopped playing it now since Splatoon has come out, unfortunately. But it's still great. And I love this one as well. It's a nice piece. It's composed by Sakuraba Motoi, and it's called Dark Pit. I like it very much. And you may like it as well. Have a listen to it. It's very cool. Awesome. That was Motoe Sakuraba, and that's Dark Pit from Kid Icarus Uprising. I haven't actually played that game properly yet. I'll probably be pretty useless at it, as is, you know, most games. But my eldest daughter, she'll probably finish it in a day, as she always does. They always kick my bum in most of these games as well. But you can't beat me at Splatoon. Definitely can't. You can't. You can't do it. Don't forget, we're here until 6 p.m. today. 6 p.m. And after this, we've got some great music, some Bhangra and, you know, Bollywood stuff. It's going to be absolutely awesome. Chai time. That's good. I like chai tea, man. It's good. Yeah, definitely. I like Earl Grey as well, though. I've got some decaffeinated Earl Grey at home as well. It's from Waitrose. Hey, seriously, this is the nicest tea, you know. It's very tasty. And it goes well with coconut milk because I can't drink cow's milk. Unfortunately, that's quite sad. Anyway, I've just gone totally off subject there here on a game video show. But, you know, anyway, we play video game music here every Thursday until 6 p.m. And we play a lot of, you know, Japanese music as well from video games. So if you hear me saying all of these different names like Kenji Kondo and Tomohito Nishiura, then, you know why. I have to say it like that because some of them are listening. I've had tweets off them, some of them as well, like, hey, that's not how you say my name. And I have to, oh, sorry, sir. You know, I'll do it properly next time. So anyway, let's play something from the guy that actually tweeted me this, something like that. He was actually really nice. I'm only joking. His name is Hirokazu Ando, and this is from Kirby Planet Robotbot. It's out now on the Nintendo 3DS. It's absolutely brilliant as well. It's not my favorite Kirby game. I do like the recent one that's come out now. What was it called? It's Curse of the Rainbow Curse or something like that. Curse of the Rainbow Curse? Or is it Rainbow Curse or something along those lines? You used a little that little stylus to tap on your Wii U gamepad as well, which is lots of fun. I'm not good at that game neither, really. I'm better at Mario Kart 8. Yeah, Mario Kart 8 Splatoon on Nintendo Wii U. But yeah, this looks good, and I do like the soundtrack. It's composed in its entirety by Hirokazu Ando as well. And there's a lot of good tracks and a lot of contrast on it as well. And I do like it very much, you know. So have a listen to this and let me know what you think as well. It's very nice. It's very nice. You're listening to the Game Video Show. We'll be out of here in a few minutes, but have a listen. Okay? Bye-bye. Well, no, don't go anywhere, actually. Stay here. Stay here. Listen to this. Okay, bye. Hirokazu Ando. That's the Robot Bot theme there from Kirby Planet Robot Bot. Yeah, really cool. Really good. It looks great. I don't understand why they never put that on the Nintendo Wii U. Like, come on. Like, why do they keep doing that? Sometimes, I dislike Nintendo because they do that. They put some of my games that I want to play on the Nintendo 3DS. And I don't have a 3DS. Could you just put it all on the same console? But hey, it's a business. I know you want me to buy a Nintendo 3DS, don't you? Very naughty. Anyway, let's play something now. We're going to go back, right back, way back, back into time with this one now. It's great. It's one of the first games that I ever played on the Sega Dreamcast. Yeah, do you remember that console? Yeah, one of the greatest consoles of all time. Definitely. I mean, I champion this console every week. Sega Dreamcast, go and buy one. The guys at Playnation Games just across the road from here, down in Croydon, they always hear me talking about, Dreamcast. Yeah, definitely. I need to get a Dreamcast bag. I saw one online. It's all leather. It looks amazing. I just need it, just to put a Dreamcast in and plug it in when I go around to my friend's house. Just unplug the Sega, what is it? Not the Sega. God, what year am I in? Unplug the Sony PS4 and throw it out the window and put in the Dreamcast. Yeah, that'd be great. Anyway, just in case someone from Sony's listening, then I'm sorry. Anyway, this is from the amazing game. It goes by the name of Crazy Taxi. Do you remember this? And it's the original theme tune from it, and from a band called The Offspring, and it's called All I Want. And it just when you first hear this this song, when you're playing, playing the game, it just sets you up for some craziness. And Crazy Taxi is just insane. It's just mad. Even playing it now, it's still mad. It just hasn't, diluted itself over the years. It's just absolutely mad. You can just roll through people and, pick them up and fling them off at Pizza Hut, etc. It's just mad. I'm going to play it later on as well. It's so good. I didn't like Crazy Taxi 2 as much. It didn't have many hills, on it. Number 1 had so many different hills. It was like in some sort of, Neo San Francisco type place. Plenty of hills and plenty of jumping over ramps as well, which is pretty insane and awesome as well at the same time. So have a listen to this one, The Offspring, All I Want from Crazy Taxi. Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Day after day.
That's nice, isn't it? Oh gosh, that's great. I love Crazy Taxi. Insane game. Great. So good. It was really, really good on the Sega Dreamcast as well. And I'm going to play that at some point tonight and pull out the Dreamcast. Well, I don't have to put it out, actually. It's already out. Yeah, it's there. It's beside the Nintendo Wii U. Can't wait. Can't wait to play that. So good. So much fun. Got my daughters into playing that as well. And they love the madcap you know, craziness of Crazy Taxi. We love it. You're listening to the Game Video Show. We've only got a few more left until we are out of the building. But don't forget, you can listen to the podcast tomorrow around 9 a.m. So you can check that out. Don't forget as well, follow at Croydon Radio online on Twitter, and you'll be able to get a good link to the podcast and listen to this show and many others on Croydon Radio. Sound like a jingle there, didn't it? Okay, let's get into this one now. This is from Portal. Do you remember this game? It was a brilliant, nutty shooter that was back out on the PC. And it's just brilliant. So good. Portal 2 was even better. Made by the same people that made Half-Life, I believe, as well. And there's not much I can say about it. Play it. You can get it so cheap now on Steam. You know, it's so easy to find, and you won't be disappointed. It's glorious, literally. And the soundtrack as well is very good. This one here is from Jonathan Coulton, and it's called Still Alive, and it plays at the end of the game as well, right at the end, and you can hear it there, and it's something special. And so much sarcasm in this track as well. You've got to listen to it. And the sort of auto-tune Vocaloid that he puts over his voice makes himself sound like a cyborg is even better. Have a listen. This is Still Alive by Jonathan Coulton. Yeah.
This was a triumph. I'm making a note here. Huge success. It's hard to overstate my satisfaction. Aperture science. We do what we must because we can. For the good of all of us, except the ones who are dead. But there's no sense crying over every mistake. You just keep on trying till you run out of cake. And the science gets done and you make a neat plan for the people who are still alive. I'm not even angry. I'm being so sincere right now. Even though you broke my heart and killed me, I'm torn into pieces and threw every piece into a fire. As they burned, it hurt because I was so happy for you. Now these points of data make a beautiful line, and we're out of data, we're releasing on time. So I'm glad I got burned. Think of all the things we learned for the people who are still alive. Go ahead and leave me. I think I prefer to stay inside. Maybe you'll find someone else to help you. Maybe Black Mesa. That was a joke. Ha ha. Bad chance. Anyway, this cake is great. It's so delicious and moist. Look at me still talking when there's science to do. When I look up there, it makes me glad I'm not.
That's brilliant, isn't it? Jonathan Coulton, Still Alive, and a bit of silence at the start there. You know, a minute of silence for a great track. Love it. Fantastic. And that's from Portal. Please play it. It's a great shooter. You can get it on Steam, originally released for the PC. Really good, really good. Portal 2 as well is something special. Very good games, along with Half-Life as well. This is going to be the last one here, and it's something from... it's something from, not from you, it's from this person here. Here we go. Atsuka Hayazaki, Atsuka Asahi, Hajime Wakai, and this is from Pikmin 3, Bingo Battle 2. It's brilliant. Have a listen to this one. Don't forget, we will be here next week, same time, on Croydon Radio from 4 p.m. to 6 p.m. 2 hours of video game music goodness as well. You can also follow us on Facebook at Game Video Show and on Twitter as well. It's at Evian Cafun. And don't forget as well, it's Croydon Radio. You can follow them. This is the radio station itself, yes. And every tweet you get from them as well, you can check out what's playing now, and what's playing tomorrow, and who's up next, and etc. Yeah, it's really simple. Anyway, I will see you next week. Have a great week. Keep it locked. Stay here for some chai tea up next. Chai times. It's going to be fantastic. Get your biscuits out and get ready to dip your tea into that one. It's going to be brilliant, seriously. Yeah. Anyway, let's get into this one. This is Bingo Battle 2 from Pikmin 3. See you next week. Bye.